What's kind of cool about mean shift a bunch of things is under some reasonable assumptions, like the shape of the thing that you put down, which is a kernel kind of thing, you can prove that in most circumstances, this thing will converge. So it'll actually find those modes. And that's really cool. So what does this have to do with tracking, you might ask?
What does this have to do with tracking?
So basically, mean shift tracking is, instead of just tracking the mean of a distribution, we're going to try to track essentially something about a distribution of a region. I'll make that clear. But our methodology is pretty similar to before. We have some position that we start with, right? And here, by the way, our initial model is not just the location, but it's this region and the size of that region. And what we have to do is we're going to search in a neighborhood in the next frame for that same description, okay? And when we do the search, we're going to move around in X, Y. We might also do things like change the scale, all right? And what we want to do is we want to find the new location, maybe scale, maybe some other change, maybe an orientation thing, that maximizes some similarity function, all right? And then we just iterate. We connect the dots. And we repeat the process, and we get this beautiful animation that says, okay, the new maximum becomes the start for the next frame.